Dear friends, welcome back. This is Nick from educates.tv and today we're going to see how to make Arduino power off itself with the help of a simple circuit. Let's start. If you have watched some of my previous videos, you will know that I like my projects to have minimal power consumption so that we can use them with batteries for a long period of time. One of the biggest disadvantages of the Arduino boards is that they need a lot of current even when in idle state. This Arduino Uno board, for example, needs around 40 milliamps when idle and about 20 milliamps if we put the 80 mega chip to sleep. That's a lot of power, so it will deplete any battery in a few days. So I wanted a circuit that will let Arduino to turn off itself instead of putting it to sleep in order to conserve power. After a lot of experimentation and googling, I finished a first basic version of this circuit. Let's see it in action. I have an Arduino board here which is battery powered. When I press the button, Arduino turns on, drives this OLED display, and all it does is to count down to its automatic power off. After 5 seconds, it will turn itself off. If I press the button again, the procedure starts over again. Great, isn't it? If I connect a multimeter, you can see that when Arduino is on, it draws around 35 milliamps of current, and when it is off, the circuit needs around half milliamp. That means that we can expand the battery life of the project to months instead of days. You can keep your Arduino on for as long as you wish, and then when it has completed its job, you can turn it off automatically. But let's now see how to build the circuit. The parts needed are these: an Arduino Uno, an I2C OLED display, a 30N06L MOSFET or any similar, two resistor, one 100K and one 330K, a push button, a breadboard and some wires. The cost of the circuit is very low, less than a dollar for the MOSFET and the resistors. You can find links for all the parts in the description of the video. The heart of the circuit is this MOSFET, which is a transistor. It works like a digital switch. If we apply 5 volts at its gate, it will allow a large amount of current to flow from the source pin to the drain pin. If there is no voltage to the gate pin of the MOSFET, no current will flow from the source to the drain pins of the MOSFET. We are going to use this feature to control the Arduino board. At first, we place all the parts on the breadboard. We place the 330K resistor between the gate and the source of the MOSFET. Next, we connect VCC from the OLED display and one leg of the button to the positive rail of the breadboard. The next step is to connect the source pin of the MOSFET to the ground rail of the breadboard. Next, we connect the middle pin of the MOSFET and the ground from the display to one of the bottom rails of the breadboard. The next step is to connect the 100K resistor to the gate pin of the MOSFET. The other end of the resistor is connected to digital pin 7 of the Arduino and the other leg of the button. Now, all we have to do is to connect the OLED display to the I2C pins of the Arduino. SDA pin goes to analog pin 4 and SEL to analog pin 5. We then connect the positive rail of the breadboard to Arduino 5V and the bottom rail to Arduino ground. That's it. We can now connect power to the upper breadboard rail and check if everything is working as expected. Great, you can find the schematic diagram of the circuit in a link in the description of the video. The code of the project is very simple. When we press the button, we apply 5 volts to the gate of the MOSFET, which makes the MOSFET to turn on. When Arduino boots up, the first thing we do is to write hi to digital pin 7. This pin is connected to the MOSFET gate. So, after releasing the button, Arduino is keeping the MOSFET on by having digital pin 7 hi. When we want to disable Arduino, all we have to do is to write low to digital pin 7. That's it! You can find the code of the project in the description of the video. As you can see, with just 4 parts we can build such a useful circuit. If you use different parts, you may be able to further reduce the power consumption of the circuit. I just used some of the parts I had available. If you achieve that or you know any design improvements, please post your setup in the comment section below in order to help the community move forward. I am going to work more on this design since it can become much more useful if we can make it able to power on by itself as well. For example, we can use a real-time clock module to enable the MOSFET instead of a push button. We can then turn this circuit into a seal to turn on Arduino at specific programmable intervals. That will be very interesting. Do you find this circuit useful, and if so, how do you plan to use it in your projects? Please post any comments or ideas in the comment section below. If this is your first time here, I would love to have you subscribed. In this channel, I post videos about do-it-yourself projects every Saturday. I love making things and I believe that anyone can make things. Anyone can become a maker. That's why I created this channel, in order to share my knowledge with the community and learn from the community. I hope you will join us. Until next Saturday, watch, learn, build.